How do you know that we're still in captivity today? That's the question.
But our people are so destroyed, they actually think that this is normal. This is not normal. You know, it's not normal to be out here with trash all over the place. You got bullet holes at the bus stop. You got people passed out, either drunk or on drugs. This is not normal. This is a bad condition. So why do we live like this? The brother's going to show you. Just give him a few minutes. Show him why we curse so he can understand the importance of knowing who you are. And more importantly, what we can do to lift these curses, because that's what he's teaching. What you gonna do in the key? We come back with you in the line is gonna burn. How you doing? Come back to teach.
Okay, great. You're not allowed to go where we want to go. What about you, sis? You got anything? Okay, I'm going to give you a simple one. They say we free, right? Hold on. I'm just saying, they say we free, right? When did we ever go back to where we came from? Aren't you still in the land of your captivity? What government do you control? What laws do you pass? Where is your military? You are still captives today. But guess what? Give me Baruch.
Behold, we are yet this day in our captivity.
There you go. We are, the Bible's prophesying, we still today in our captivity. Can you read?
When thou hast scattered us for a reproach and a curse.
So who scattered us in? The Lord. Why? Because he was mad because we didn't do what? Keep the commandments. Understand, the most important thing that y'all can do for yourself is keep the laws. Call them numbers. Get in contact with us. Start changing. No more pants, dresses, hand wraps. Y'all look beautiful. Y'all look beautiful.
Give me that Genesis.
The book of Genesis, chapter 32, verse 28. And he said, thy name shall be called no more Jacob, but Israel. For a prince hast thou power with God.
So that's what your name is. Your last name should be Israel. Your last name shouldn't be Johnson, Smith, Dixon,
Jackson,
Jones. Where you get these names from? Your plantation owner. That's where you get your name. But your name is supposed to be Israel. And your name has meaning. It means you have power with God. That's what your last name should say. Read.
With God and with man, it has prevailed.
So if he called us the prince, what are you sisters? Y'all the princes. And you ain't never seen a princess walk around in pants.
That's right.
You ain't never seen it. Understand that y'all royalty, that y'all special. Give me 1 Peter 2 and 9, and I'm going to bring up the next teacher. Your sisters look beautiful in your dresses, man. You got to understand, by you wearing a dress, you keep the whoremonger spirit off our brothers. Because you show your shape. And when a man see your shape, what do he want to do? Lay with you and keep it moving. Understand that. Read.
The book of 1 Peter, chapter 2, verse 9. But ye are a chosen generation.
I told you a chosen generation.
A royal priesthood.
You're royalty. And if you a princess, princesses, that's royalty. Like I said, you would never see a princess walk around in pants. That's a new thing in the earth. If you go back to a lot of the other countries, they're not even wearing pants. Women don't wear pants. It's confusion. If you go to any country on this planet right now, you had to use the bathroom and you couldn't speak the language, how would you know you were in the right bathroom? How would you know? Is not a sign on the bathroom door? With what? Address. It's universal. You can't get around it. That's what the God's trying to tell you. Come back to what he told you to do. Read.
But ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, and holy nation, a peculiar people.
Peculiar people. That basically is telling you special. There's nobody like you. You got to understand, of us still being oppressed today, and still having our mind to be able to think all the inventions that we created. You see the red light, the yellow, green. A black man created that. But guess what? That controls how traffic moves. That's important. That's how it helps the city run. If there was no red light, how everybody could be just driving all over the place, it'd be chaos. That's structure. Like I said earlier, what was the name of the man that helped design the area?
Benjamin Banneker.
Helped design DC. Not even with the blueprint. He saw the blueprint once and he remembered it off his mind. They're special people. But a lot of times we always talk about sports and singing and dancing. Your intellect is way better than these people. You was in slavery, working 20 plus hours a day, getting your butt whipped, and you sitting there thinking about, well, I'm going to build something. Think about the mind that you got to have to be able to withstand all that torture and still have your mind. Have y'all ever had treatment? You know what they say when a Caucasian kills somebody, they say he need mental health. He needs help. Where was our people's help? When did we get help? This Bible's your help. Bible's your help. It's going to heal you. You know who you are now. You know what you must do to get the kingdom of God. Now, I'm going to give you the question you should have asked. Give me that in Matthew 16. This is the question that everybody should ask. How do you get the kingdom of heaven?
The book of Matthew, chapter 19, verse 16. And behold, one came and said unto him, good master, what good things shall I do that I may have eternal life?
So the question was asked to Christ, what must I do to have eternal life? Live forever in the kingdom of what? Heaven, right? So this is a very, very important scripture, right?
And he said unto him, why callest thou me good? There is none good but one.
So Christ said, there's only one good. Let's see who's good.
That is God.
God and Christ ain't the same. You see? You was taught that in Christianity. Read it again so she can understand.
And he said, why callest thou me good?
So Christ saying to the man that asked the question, why are you calling me good? He's about to give you the answer who's really good.
There is none good but one.
So Christ has said there's none good but one.
That is God.
That is who?
God.
So God is good. That's what Christ is saying. So that's showing you that there's a separation between Christ and God. You understand that sense? Read.
But if thou wilt enter into life.
But if you want the kingdom of heaven, if you want to live forever.
Keep the commandment.
It goes back to the commandments, y'all. It's very important to know the commandments. You're not getting in that gate without knowing the commandments of God. And I don't want to say that gate because it's 12. I know in Christianity they taught you it's one gate you're going through. Let's get that real quick. This is my last scripture. I'm going to bring up the next teacher. Christianity taught you we all going through that one pearly gate. No. Let's see if that's in the Bible.
The book of Revelation, chapter 21, verse 12. It had a wall great and high. It had 12 gates.
It had how many gates?
12 gates.
It had how many gates?
12 gates.
Who y'all think them gates for?
Bring it up.
We're going to read it.
And at the gates, 12 angels.
What those angels doing at the gates? You ever try to get into a building you ain't have access to? And they had that bodyguard standing out there? That's what them angels doing. You ain't getting in unless you are these nations, right? Of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel. That's why you got 12 gates.
And names written thereon, which are the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel.
Y'all see who getting through them gates?
Now y'all see
working so hard to serve God. And why would I say that I'm a Jew? It's our art. For years I've been walking around saying that I'm a black man. I ain't saying that no more. It's our fault, man.
This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.